According to local leaders, several oil activities have been implemented in the district, but they are not being involved in the process of exploration. Dizelis Kabahangwire, the Chikube District Youth Councillor, says very few people from Chikube District have clear information about the progress of the oil and gas sector. He asked for more engagement meetings to keep communities up to date.
Some of us might know of the opportunities, but a few have benefited. There are trainings that have been going on. I appreciate the training that has gone on of recent. They've taken people for training in welding, coded welding. Students are back already, they've been trained. But these are very few students that they've trained out of the whole district. I'm calling for more training. I'm calling for more engagement so that the people of Chikube, let them know what is taking place in the oil and gas. And let them get these opportunities so that they can easily, they can benefit when oil drops out.
Susan Kabahindi, the Buhimba Town Council District Councillor, has decried the information gap between the oil companies and the host communities.
There's a lot of gap between the beneficiaries and those partners. So we'd love them to always engage us as leaders from top to bottom, so that people can know of what they are doing, because some of them get opposition from villages because those people are not in the know.
Francis Kazini Tuinom Juni, the Buhaguzi County Legislator, is demanding accountability of any oil-related activities in the district.
When they were, because of their budget and their activities, sometimes they may not change their things. But there came a time when they were laying off some of the workers.
Robert Biaruhanga, a consultant in oil and gas, notes that the national local content policy provides for participation of local leaders. Biaruhanga adds that a number of infrastructures are being constructed in Chikube and have impact on the host communities.
The district needs to come in handy to engage, to ensure that the district benefits from these programs that have been created by these oil companies, and also to look into the docket of the oil companies to ensure that whatever has been planned is executed to the latter. In sort of this, the district might lose out. They are going to start constructing the central processing facility. You find that the various oil parties are going to start to be expounded. They are going to drill over 40 oil wells within the area. They are going to start constructing the pipeline, and that all these activities are going to have impact on the people. That is the reason why the district must come up to prepare the people and to ensure that the livelihoods of the people are improved, and to ensure that the local people also benefit from the industry.
Paul Mulindwa, the Chitara Civil Society Organization's Network Executive Director, says the target is people's elected representatives in mainstream politics and local leaders at sub-county, parish and village levels.
We'll also be talking to the stakeholders in the Nyaru Kitara Kingdom, or BKK, on the same mission, trying to sensitize them to be aware of what is happening in the oil and gas.
Purposeful capacity building in the areas of ordinances and the like. So as at the end of the day, when we are presenting our needs and demands to these dear companies of oil and gas, we are seen to be a little bit capable and with the direction.
Chikube District is among the host districts of key oil and gas projects like the Kabale International Airport, an oil refinery that is going to be constructed in Buhuka, the East African crude oil pipeline, among others. Report by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news in Chikube.